So what's your predictions on the Pacquiao and Spence fight coming up?
Well, I mean, obviously Premier Boxing Champions did a great job putting that fight together. I think that was the biggest fight you could make. You know, you had Spence and Ugas, you had rumors of that was going down for the WBA title, but Pacquiao's the name. He's a legend in the sport, and when I heard the fight being announced, I was like, absolutely insane that Pacquiao's even taking that fight. I think obviously Spence is the favorite. If I had to put money down, I'd go with Spence. But I mean, Manny has proven us wrong so many times before. He did it against Keith Thurman. We didn't think he'd be able to beat a guy like Keith Thurman, and he ended up doing it. So Spence cannot overlook Manny, and I don't think he's going to. And Manny, I mean, for a lot of guys, it'd be ring rust being out of the ring for 2 years once that fight, they step into the ring. But for Manny, I think it's actually a good thing because his body, being 42 years old, has been able to heal up. And he's going to be able to put 110% into that fight and really dedicate. And hopefully, I think for Manny, win or lose, just by him taking that fight, it just proves why he's that legend, man.
Benares and Devin Haney, who do you got on that fight?
I mean, that's a great fight. I'm actually pretty shocked that Linares is such a massive underdog. Linares, yeah, he's 35, but, you know, he's super talented, and Haney can't really overlook a guy like Linares. I think it's going to be really, really good. I do have Haney winning because I think Haney's just so technical and his IQ is just off the charts. But he can't overlook a guy like Linares, who's such a heavy hitter. It's a good fight, and I don't think the odds are as great as what it says. And if I were there, I'll put a little bit of money on Linares. I mean, the odds are too great to pass up and not put a little bit on Linares.
That's actually what they're doing in Vegas. They're actually putting money more on Linares just for the simple fact that he is a heavy underdog.
Such a massive underdog, yeah.
Yeah, he's a massive underdog. So it's a huge win if Linares can pull the upset.
Yeah. It's kind of...
It's not likely. It can happen.
Yeah, it's similar like how when the odds were so stacked against Andy Ruiz in the first Joshua fight. It was like, if you've seen Andy fight, he's got a chance. And what happened, I'm sure the casinos weren't too happy and the sports books weren't too happy with that one. So this is kind of a similar situation. I don't think the odds are justifiable for why Linares is such a massive underdog.
Fury and Wilder, the trilogy is going to happen. What's your thoughts on that?
That's an awesome fight. I think Wilder has been smart, being very quiet in the training. You know, he definitely has to mix it up. He can't come out like I did in the second one. I mean, and when you talk about the Bronze Bomber, he's got that one punch any given Sunday, you know, that he can knock you out. And Fury, I mean, he's certainly the favorite, but it seems like just by the way he's acting and, you know, going about his business, that he's almost overlooking Deontay a little bit. And Deontay, mind you, he was the champ, heavyweight champ for years, knocking everybody out. He knocked Fury out twice in the first one. So this is not a fight that Fury can take lightly. I definitely wouldn't put it past Deontay to pull off the upset. And that's another one where I'm sure, depending on how the odds are going to look for that fight, Deontay might be nice to put a shekel or two down on him to make some nice coins. So it's going to be a great fight. I'm excited. I'm pumped. Las Vegas has two massive fights coming their way with Spence and Pacquiao, Wilder and Fury. So PBC has done an excellent job putting these fights together, man. I'm excited.
I agree. Last but not least, Tank and Barrios.
This is a dangerous fight. It's a dangerous fight for Tank. It proves that Tank, I think, is willing to take on anyone. Barrios is a guy that, you know, when this fight was announced, a lot of the casual fans kind of were like, oh, Tank's running and, you know, doing that. But those are the people that haven't seen Barrios fight. Barrios is a heavy hitter, and he's got some really big power punching. And this is a fight that could make him, you know. This is a fight where if you beat a guy like Tank with the name that he carries, you're into that superstar, you know, era of boxers right now, and he's a young kid. So obviously Tank, I think, is taking on a massive challenge. I got Tank winning by body shot, but I mean, this is gonna be one of those fights that I think could be a sneaky fight of the year candidate.
There you guys have it, thank you.